Hi, I'm Mr. Beat. In this video, we will introduce the basics of supply and demand by discussing different market structures based on competition. Markets are the foundation of the interactions between buyers and sellers that we call supply and demand. Economists refer to a market as a group of buyers and sellers of a particular good or service. Markets can be in person, like a mall or grocery store, or online, like Amazon or eBay. Although modern markets typically involve currency as the medium of exchange, bartering and trading were also used as methods of transactions in markets like the trading posts along the Oregon Trail. The importance of markets rests in the ability to set the prices of goods and services, which are determined by supply and demand. The most common form of market is a competitive market. A competitive market is a market in which there are as many buyers and sellers so that each has a negligible impact on the market price. The key phrase here is, quote, negligible impact on the market price. This implies that no seller or buyer is large enough to be able to influence the market prices. The other idea implied here is that the market forces of supply and demand are what co-determine the price of the good or service in a competitive market. Now, let's turn to different types of competition and how they form different market structures. For our discussion, we'll assume that these markets are perfectly competitive. A perfectly competitive market must satisfy two conditions. First, the goods or services in the market must be homogeneous, or all the same. Second, there must be a large enough number of buyers and sellers that no one can influence the market price. Economists refer to these market participants as price takers. An example of a perfectly competitive market is the market for agricultural products, such as russet potatoes. The first condition is satisfied because all russet potatoes are, and should be, the same. So you as a buyer do not care who or where you are getting the potatoes from. The second condition is also satisfied because there are so many potato sellers and buyers that no one party can influence the market price of potatoes in any major way. On the other end of the spectrum, some markets have many buyers, but only one seller. This gives the seller the pricing power, while the buyers are still price takers. In this situation, the seller is referred to as a monopoly. For example, utility companies, such as your electricity provider, may be a monopoly. In real life, many markets fall between perfect competition and monopoly. The consumer gasoline market, for example, may be categorized as an oligopoly, where a small number of suppliers, such as BP, Shell, and Chevron, collectively control the market. Another type of market is monopolistically competitive. Monopolistically competitive markets have a large number of buyers and sellers, but the goods or services provided in the markets are slightly differentiated so that the sellers have some degree of pricing power. An example of this is the apparel market. There are many apparel brands that occupy the market, but each brand may have a niche that differentiates their products from other brands. This allows the brand some wiggle room in setting its own price. If you want to explore these topics in more depth, come visit Chegg, where you can see additional topic videos and example problems, or you can ask our Chegg subject matter experts for help on specific problems. Thanks for watching.